Welcome students. In our today's class, we are going to read a very important poem by H.W. Longfellow, Call for Peace. What is the name of the poem? Call for Peace. It is a very important lyric poem by H.W. Longfellow that describes the caution that the supreme being, that God, is given to the warring tribes, to the mankind who are fighting with each other. What do you think of war? What happens when people and nation fight with each other? So the poet is posing a question that what do you think of war? War? Do you glorify it, or are you terrified of the war? What happens when people and nation fight with each other? The Song of Hiawatha is an epic poem based on Native American mythology. So, the Song of Hiawatha is an epic poem. What is an epic poem? Epic poems are, we have our epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata, just like it is also an epic poem that is based on Native American mythology. Mythology means some kind of saying, some kind of story that is going on for ages, that we learn from our grandfather and grandmother has learned from theirs. So an epic poem describes some kind of epic incidents, war, about God, about wrongdoing, good thing, this kind of things. It describes the legend of an American Indian chief of the Onondaga tribe. So the poem describes the Song of Hiawatha describes the legend of an American Indian chief of the Onondaga tribe called Hiawatha. So he was called Hiawatha. This poem is an extract from them. Okay, from the poem speaks of Geechee Manito. So the poem, our poem Call for Peace, talks about Geechee Manito, the supreme being. What is the meaning of supreme being? The almighty God who has created everything, who created all and filled everything with life force. So basically God. He comes down from the skies and tells the warring tribes of the earth to stop fighting and live peacefully. Read this extract to find out how he tries to persuade people to live in harmony. What is the meaning of the word persuade? Persuade means convincing someone to something. Okay. He persuades people to live in harmony. So let us begin to read the poem. Geechee Manito, the mighty, the creator of the nations, looked upon them with compassion, with paternal love and pity, looked upon their rage and wranglings as quarrels among children, but as feuds and fights of children. Over them he stretched his right hand to calm their stubborn natures, to cool their thirst and fever by the shadow of his right hand. Speak to them with voice majestic, as the sound of far-off waters falling into deep abysses, warning, chiding, speak in these words. So, what do you see in our first para? In our first para, Geechee Manito, the Almighty, is scolding. Scolding, the creator of the nation is looking upon the warring tribes of the earth with compassion. Compassion means a kind of sense of love, pity and sympathy, with paternal love and pity. What is the meaning of the word paternal love? Paternal means fatherly love. So, he looked upon them with compassion, with paternal love and pity. Compassion means sympathy, and with paternal love and pity. Paternal means fatherly love and pity. Looked upon their rage and wrangling, but as quarrels among children. Geechee Manito looked upon their rage. Rage means anger, and wrangling means the argumentative nature, but as quarrels among children, but as feuds and fights of children. So he looked upon their rage and wrangling, their quarrels, as fight among children. Feud means fight. Over them he stretched his right hand. So Gita Manito, in the posture of giving blessings, stretches right hand to calm their stubborn nature. Stubborn means nature that someone unwilling to change. To cool their thirst and fever, to cool their thirst for war and bloodshed. Fever here means extreme nervous disturbance or worry. To cool their worry, he stretches right hand in a posture of giving blessings. By the shadow of his right hand, speak to them with voice majestic. What is the meaning of the word speak? The word speak refers to the is a old English word that means speak. So here it refers spoke. So with his majestic voice, which is with his echoing voice, he speak to them. He spoke to them as the sound of far off waters, as the sound that are falling in a far off land, falling into deep abysses. Abysses mean a hole that is bottomless, a bottomless hole. Warning, chiding, speak in this word. So he gave them warning, he scolded them and spoke to them in this word. So in our next paragraph, in our next stanza, we are going to see what Gita Manito asked them, what warning he gave them. So here in this paragraph, in this stanza, we are going to see what are those warnings that Gita Manito tried to give them. Oh my children, my poor children, listen to the words of wisdom, listen to the words of warning from the lips of the greatest spirit, from the master of life who made you. So Gita Manito is referring himself as the master of life, who has made all the humankind. He is calling them, oh my children, my poor children, listen to the words of wisdom, listen to the words of the wise, listen to the words of warning. I am warning you, listen to me. From the lips of the great spirit, from the lips of the greatest spirit, who has made you. I have given, now Gita Manito is referring to the things that God has given us to be contented with whatever we have. I have given you lands to hunt in. I have given you streams to fish in. So he is saying that I have given you lands for hunting. I have given you streams to fish in. I have given you bear and bison. I have given you bears and bisons. I have given you roe and reindeer. What is the meaning of the word roe? Roe means the eggs of the fishes. And reindeer, I think all of you know that draws the carriage of Santa Claus every year for all of you. I have given you brant and beaver. What is the meaning of brant? Brant means North. Brant is a North American term for small gooses. Okay, and beaver means a kind of furry animal with a big fat tail. Fill the marshes full of wildfowl. Marshes mean a kind of low land filled with still water, with wildfowl. Fill the rivers full of fishes. I have filled the river with fishes. Why then you are not contented? Why then are you not contented? He is asking. Contented means satisfied. He is asking, then why are you not satisfied, my children? Why then will you hunt each other? Why are you hunting each other? I am wary of your quarrels. Gita Manito is saying that I am very much wary of your quarrels. Wary of your words and bloodshed. I am very much wary of your words and words that you are fighting and bloodshed. Bloodshed means killing or wounding of a lot of people and very of your prayers for vengeance. I am weary of your prayer for vengeance. Vengeance means revenge taken from injury or wrongdoing. Of your wranglings and disagreements, I am very much weary. I am very much tired of your fighting with each other and disagreements with each other. All your strength is in your union. So, Kicha Manito is giving the message here that your strength is in your union. All your strength is in your union. All your danger in discord. Discord means disagreement or argument between people. Therefore, be at peace henceforth. He is asking with his blessings to be at peace from now. Henceforth means on from now. As brothers live together. Therefore, be at peace and live like brothers live together. So, with this our poem is completed. And what does the poem call for peace teaches us? What does Kicha Manito teach us? He teaches us that all our strength lies in our unity, and our falling, our unsuccessfulness, our danger lies if we fight with each other, if we give others a scope to take advantage of our fight. So the poem called for peace by H.W. Longfellow is a call for peace on behalf of Kicha Manito, who is asking the warring tribes not to fight and be at peace with each other. Okay, student, with this we finish our class today, and all your study notes have been uploaded in the Google Classroom, and in our Google Meet we have discussed the exercise part. Okay, student, bye.